looking into the affairs of this world. I mean, subhanAllah, obviously, when you look into what's going on in Syria and you see the people are even willing to die, they're riding what I call the arcs of death. These arcs of death and the ships and the boats of death, they know that's not even a 50-50 chance anymore. With the high rate of mortality and death during the season when the weather is changing, the climate is changing, people know it's perhaps maybe it's 30% survive, 70% death, they're still taking chances. Whenever you see what's going on to the Muslims in Iraq or in Bangladesh or Rohingya or even anywhere in the world, when you look at that, many Muslims, they feel, subhanAllah, helpless and hopeless, especially living here in America. I know a brother who came as a refugee over here. Allah blessed him with this status. He came to this country. He got married. He sought asylum and he got it and he just lived his life over here. But until now, he's still struggling with his marriage and his life. Why is that? Because he's feeling guilty that he's having it comfortably here while his family is still suffering there. So they have this now, they're feeling guilty being alive, feeling guilty that having everything, alhamdulillah, given to them, you know, on a golden plate. They're just guilty at it. Why do you have to feel guilty? If Allah bless you with this, use it for the best you can, inshallah, tabaraka wa ta'ala. You don't have to feel guilty that you're, alhamdulillah, you're wealthy. You don't have to feel guilty because you have education, because you have a community, you have a house, you have a roof over your head. You don't have to feel guilty for that. Instead, use it, this ni'mah, and be grateful for this ni'mah, and then take it to the next level with the people. That you try to help them in the way that, inshallah, ta'ala, you can, bidnillahi azza wa jal. So these young men and women, when they see the condition of the world, and they see that political leaders, religious leaders are not moving anywhere, not doing anything about it, they start kind of feeling that they've been betrayed, they get upset, they get angry, and eventually some of them, they might decide to leave Islam, and others perhaps would go and make that radical decision and make the wrong actually choice. Many of our brothers and sisters, the young ones today, what they do, they romanticize the past. So every time we hear a situation that is happening, they always bring you examples like Salah ad-Din al-Ayyubi, Umar ibn Khattab radiallahu ta'ala, like, where are you guys from these people? Well, I would answer this question like Ali ibn Abi Talib when he answered some people who came to him. After the Battle of Siffin, a man came to Ali ibn Abi Talib, he said, why did the people like disagree on you when they have agreed on men like Abu Bakr as-Siddiq and Umar? Like telling Ali, you are the problem. Because Abu Bakr didn't have a problem, Umar didn't have a problem. How come the people, they fight now over you and they didn't do that with Abu Bakr and Umar? What was the answer of Ali radiallahu ta'ala? He said to him, because the people of Umar and Abu Bakr as-Siddiq were Ali ibn Abi Talib and people like me. And my people are you and people like you. So sometimes the reason we're going through all this dilemma in our lives is because of our actions. It's us. The choices we make as a community can lead to this result.